Very good evening. I'm Shilpa and I welcome you all to the NCERT live phone-in program. Isn't it interesting to know how social science perspective has evolved and how interdisciplinary perspective will actually help us in eradicating societal issues and challenges? We will know all of these today because our today's topic of discussion is perspective in social sciences. And to discuss this topic in our studio, we have Professor Gauri Srivastav, who is the professor and head of the Department of Education in Social Sciences in NCERT. I welcome you, Professor Gauri.
Welcome.
So let's proceed to understand this very significant topic.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity. I think social sciences is a very important subject, and it consists of different contours of disciplines like history, geography, economics, sociology, psychology, commerce. All these subjects together play a very important role in understanding social dimensions that exist in our society. Now, every subject has its own rigor and methodology, but in an age of interdisciplinary approaches where we want to understand societal issues in depth, it is very important to have a perspective, interdisciplinary as well as interdisciplinary within the discipline and across the discipline, because this will help the children to understand that any issues, whether it is social, anything related to environment, can be handled if we adopt a multi-pronged approach.
Okay.
And therefore, these approaches that are emerging today are actually loosening the tight boundaries that earlier people used to understand. So, it is very important for us to focus on the interdisciplinary perspectives within the subject as well as across the subject. And I think from my own experience of understanding social sciences, because I know at the jab hum school mein the to hame sara padhna padta tha, tab humne hamesha usko dekha, acha ye history hai, ye geography hai, lekin ab dheere dheere as a professional and अपने जितने भी मैंने शोध कार्य किए, मुझे लगा कि हर विषय को अगर थीम को लेते हैं, कहीं ना कहीं विषय का जुड़ाव है. और इसी को नज़र रखते हुए मैंने ये डायग्राम बनाया, आप देख सकते हैं, perspectives in social sciences, interrelation within the discipline and across the discipline. ये मैंने इसलिए बनाया कि आप भी बना सकते हैं, और जब भी आप अपने विषय को पढ़ें तो इसको सामने रखिए एंड आपको पता चलेगा कि विषयवार जुड़ाव कैसे है. कई बार इफ माय एक्सपीरियंस ऑफ लुकिंग इनटू टेक्स्ट बुक्स ऑफ मेनी कंट्रीज एज वेल एज आवर ओन कंट्री टेक्स्ट बुक्स, आई फाउंड दैट सम टाइम यू नो यू हैव थीम्स दैट मे और मे नॉट शो द इंटर रिलेशन, बट व्हेन यू गो डेप्थ एंड स्टार्ट एग्जामिनिंग इट, कहीं ना कहीं जुड़ाव आपको दिखेगा. तो ये एक एक्सरसाइज है आपके लिए, और इस फिगर को देख करके आप अपने आप देखिए कि जो विषय आप पढ़ रहे हैं, क्या आपको ये जुड़ाव दिख रहा है कि नहीं. मेक दिस डायग्राम और मेक अ बेटर डायग्राम. फिर दूसरा विच आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर विद यू इज, नाउ वी लेट अस कम टू अंडरस्टैंडिंग हाउ कैन यू अंडरस्टैंड इंटर रिलेशंस विद इन द डिसिप्लिन. नाउ इसके लिए मैंने आपको एक छोटा सा डायग्राम बनाया है, जिसमें मैंने विषय लिया है इतिहास, हिस्ट्री. देन द सेकेंड एस्पेक्ट इज द थीम, बिकॉज अ थीम इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. विदाउट डीलिमिटिंग टू अ थीम, इट विल नॉट बी वेरी इजी फॉर यू टू एस्टैब्लिश द इंटरलिंकेजेस. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ आई टेक एनी थीम इन हिस्ट्री, देन द सेकेंड थिंग इन दिस डायग्राम इज वेयर हैज इट अकर्ड, एंड द थर्ड थिंग इज what is the role of the state. When we pose such a question, we are actually looking in terms of interrelationship within the discipline. Now, maine kuch questions bhi aapke liye banaye, aap dekh sakte hain. Theme aap soch lijiye, any theme that you want to think about, then you put these questions: when did it occur, what were the issues, which sections of society was affected, which places were affected, what was the role of the state. ऐसे सवाल हम पूछेंगे तो हम उस थीम जो हमने चयनित किया है, हम इसका इंटरलिंकेजेस ढूंढ सकते हैं. मिसाल के रूप से, अगर हमने किसी आंदोलन के बारे में चर्चा किया, It could be a civil disobedience movement, it could be quit India movement, कोई भी ले लीजिए अपने अपने इतिहास की किताब से, फिर आप ये आपके अंदर ये प्रश्न बनाइए, क्योंकि for an interdisciplinary approach, you need to have a questioning mind. जब आप सवाल पूछेंगे, अपने आप आपको उसका जवाब आएगा. इस अप्रोच का दो फायदा है. You are actually preparing yourself for understanding the subject well. दूसरा, आप जो भी प्रश्न आपके इम्तहान में आता है, उसका भी आप अच्छी तरह तैयारी कर सकते हैं. You don't have to learn, क्योंकि कई बार इतिहास में लोगों को लगता है ये विषय केवल यू नो तारीखों से जुड़ा है जिसे हमें रखना चाहिए. लेकिन जब आप ऐसे सवाल आप बना के रखते हैं और ये अप्रोच अडॉप्ट करते हैं, तो आपको विषय की अच्छी समझ होती है और आप उसको ऐसे अच्छी तरह समझ लेंगे और आप ये जानने की कोशिश करेंगे कि क्या बात है, उस समय आंदोलन के कारण क्या थे और आज जो आंदोलन होते हैं उसके क्या कारण हैं.
जी,
नाउ लिंकेजेस जब आप एस्टैब्लिश करते हैं, देखिए मैंने कहीं पढ़ा था टाइम स्पेस एंड इंस्टीट्यूशन, और आज भी मैं इसको याद करती हूँ और दिमाग में मेरे रहता है, दे आर कैची वर्ड्स, कि कैसे ये जुड़ाव होता है, कि ये जैसे कोई आंदोलन एक जगह शुरू होता है, उस स्थान का क्या नाम है, व्हेन वी गो टू हिस्ट्री, पेजेस ऑफ हिस्ट्री, वाज इट सिचुएटेड इन अ प्रोविंस, व्हेन द मूवमेंट स्टार्टेड, विच वर द प्लेसेस दैट वर एसोसिएटेड. फिर आप एक सवाल पूछिए, क्या उन जगहों का नाम आज भी वही है, क्या वो सीमाएँ आज भी हैं. तो आप पुराने मैप मानचित्र को लीजिए और आज के मानचित्र को लीजिए, और आपका जुड़ाव इतना अधिक हो जाएगा कि आप इतिहास से भूगोल की तरफ चले गए.
जी.
और फिर साथ साथ आप उस वक्त एक और प्रश्न पूछिए कि ये आंदोलन को कैसे सरकार ने इसके तरफ अपना नीति बनाया.
जी.
वॉज इट रिप्रेस्ड, वॉट वॉज द गवर्नमेंट स्ट्रैटेजी, एंड टुडे व्हेन अ मूवमेंट स्टार्ट्स, वॉट इज अ स्ट्रैटेजी. तो जो हम कहते हैं डायलॉगिंग बिटवीन द पास्ट एंड प्रेजेंट को डूएबल्स में आप इन प्रश्नों के माध्यम से आप इसका हल निकाल सकते हैं. आपको याद भी रहेगी और विषय में रुचि आएगी. तो ये हमने आपको एक छोटा सा एग्जांपल विषय में इतिहास को लेकर बताया. इसी तरह हमने एक और विषय लिया वेयर आई वॉन्ट यू टू अंडरस्टैंड द रिलेशनशिप अक्रॉस द सब्जेक्ट. ये भी एक बहुत अच्छी चीज़ है, क्योंकि जब आप कई बार पढ़ते हैं और ख़ास तौर से स्कूल में आप देखिए, आपका एक ही टीचर कई बार दोनों इतिहास, ज्योग्राफी, इकोनॉमिक्स सब विषय पढ़ाते हैं.
जी.
तो ये डायग्राम के माध्यम से आप इसको बेहतर समझ सकते हैं. अब मैंने एक विषय लिया विमेंस एजुकेशन. विमेंस एजुकेशन आप पूछेंगे क्यों लिया, क्योंकि मैंने अपने शोध कार्य में इस विषय पे अध्ययन किया और हमने पाया कि इस विषय में हर विषय का जुड़ाव है.
ओके.
और आधुनिक स्थिति से भी आप जोड़ सकते हैं, क्योंकि आप देखिए हम विमेन एम्पावरमेंट की बात करते हैं, पार्टिसिपेशन ऑफ विमेन इन अनकन्वेंशनल रोल, वी ऑल्सो टॉक अबाउट स्टेटस ऑफ विमेन, इतनी चीज़ों को हम ध्यान में रखते हुए बात करते हैं. तो ऐसे में हर विषय का जुड़ाव कैसे है, तो ये भी हम प्रश्नों के माध्यम से बताएंगे. आप भी कर सकते हैं, प्रोजेक्ट बना सकते हैं, विषय को गहराई से समझ सकते हैं. नाउ द थीम इज विमेन्स एजुकेशन. नाउ हम क्या, व्हाट आर द क्वेश्चंस दैट आई कैन पोज, व्हेन डिड द फॉर्मल एजुकेशन ऑफ विमेन स्टार्ट. व्हेन यू पोज अ क्वेश्चन लाइक दिस, यू गो बैक टू द पेजेस ऑफ हिस्ट्री, डाउन द मेमोरी लेन. Who, what were the institutions that were opened for women? What kind of courses were women accessing on? Then, which were the areas that became more popular centers of women? Then you go back to the pages of history. Then when you pose another question, what were the agencies that were promoting women's education? वो कौन सी ऐसी एजेंसी थी, सरकारी, गैर सरकारी, जिन्होंने महिलाओं की शिक्षा को आगे बढ़ाया. इसमें आप बता सकते हैं कि दे वर द एजुकेटेड इंडियंस देमसेल्स, बोथ मेन एंड वुमेन. देन यू हैव द क्रिश्चियन मिशनरीज, देन यू हैड द ब्रिटिश गवर्नमेंट. ऑल दीज थ्री एजेंसीज वर्क टूवर्ड्स प्रमोटिंग फॉर्मल एजुकेशन ऑफ वुमेन. दूसरा सवाल क्या हो सकता है, कि जो शिक्षित महिलाएं थी उन्होंने क्या किया, उसमें आपको फिर इतिहास में जाना पड़ेगा कि कई शिक्षित महिलाओं ने संस्थाएं शुरू की। फॉर एग्जांपल पंडिता रमाबाई सरस्वती ने शारदा सदन शुरू किया और इस सदन ने महिलाओं को शिक्षित ही नहीं किया बल्कि उन्हें कौशलता का भी ज्ञान दिया जिससे वे स्वावलंबी हों और दूसरों को भी प्रेरणा दें। देन यू हैड वीमेन हु हेल्प्ड अदर वीमेन टू टेक टू प्रोफेशंस लाइक टीचिंग वॉज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन द 19th सेंचुरी एंड दिस इज हाउ सर्टन क्वेश्चंस टेक यू डीप डाउन टू अंडरस्टैंड वो कारण जो किसी थीम के बारे में आपको पूछने की ज़रूरत है, सोचने की ज़रूरत है। देन विच वर द प्रेसिडेंसीज विच वर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, यू नो बॉम्बे प्रेसिडेंसी, बंगाल प्रेसिडेंसी एंड समटाइम इवन प्रिंसली स्टेट प्रमोटेड एजुकेशन ऑफ वीमेन। देन हाउ डिड एजुकेशन ऑफ वीमेन हेल्प इन द फ्रीडम स्ट्रगल ऑफ इंडिया? We know that there were legend makers, there were women who were leading the struggle, but there were others who followed and they also were equally capable because koi bhi andolan ek vyakti se nahi chalta hai, uska judaav hota hai. Kehne ka matlab ye hai ki aap jab aise prashn poochte hain to aap itihas se jud jate hain, sthan ki jab charcha karte hain to aapka vishay geography ho jata hai, government policies mein aap you enter into the domain of political science and psychology also, because when you ask about what was those women, unka self ka, were they motivated? What did they do with their education? Did they feel empowered? And we find that women who were educated, they took to profession, like you have Cornelia Sarabji, you have so many men who came forward and they took leadership roles in different struggle. महिलाओं ने शायद फॉर्मल एजुकेशन नहीं लिया हो बट दे वर नॉलेजेबल और उन्होंने हर आंदोलन में भाग लिया, उन्होंने लोगों को प्रेरणा दी, गीत गाए, साथ ही साथ उन्होंने खाना दिया और चरखा चलाया, खादी को का प्रचार किया। सो दिस शोज दैट इट इज द लिंकेजेस हैव एक्चुअली टच्ड अपॉन ऑल डोमेन्स ऑफ नॉलेज एंड दिस इज वन ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ going beyond a subject like history to other domains of social sciences. While doing this, you will ask me a question. One, are we following a logical step? Is it a perspective that we need to focus upon? Mere samajh se bilkul sahi, ye hona chahiye, because when you start questioning and reasoning out, automatically the logical a way of understanding a phenomena or a thing becomes very clear.
Ma'am, I'll also come to this point. What's the benefit people will get if they'll follow this? Because you just told us how a theme is related to all the subjects, which is history, geography, political science.
You're very right. I think it has a lot of advantage because it's not just stopping at the school stage. आपको आगे भी इस विषय को पढ़ना है, शायद आपके अंदर कोई जिज्ञासा हो कि मैं एजुकेशन में काम करूं, या आप में से कई पॉलिसी मेकर्स हो सकते हैं, कई समाज की कुछ कुरूतियां हैं उनको सुधारने की कोशिश कर सकते हैं। सो यू हैव टू चूज एंड व्हेन वी गो टू हायर स्टडीज़ वी आल्सो मेक अ चॉइस व्हाइल डूइंग आवर रिसर्च और व्हाइल डूइंग आवर थीसिस। सो दिस अप्रोच विल हेल्प यू टू फर्स्ट बिकम क्रिएटिव एंड थिंक whether I can do this theme, and while putting these questions, your interest, your creativity, your logical way of following a path will get more chiseled, and it will help you to come to maybe something innovative, something creative, you never know. So this is why we follow interdisciplinary approach. Following methodologies today, we don't have one-to-one methodologies. Today also we follow different methodologies for arriving at a body of knowledge that gives you perhaps, you know, moving to a realistic picture of understanding a phenomena from different points of view. And I think that is what is need of the hour. So this is what right. I would like to put it like that.
Okay. So ma'am, you just talked about the interdisciplinary perspective in a way, but how it actually helping us in dealing with the societal challenges?
Oh, that's a very good question that you have asked. I think today our society is facing different types of challenges. Mm-hmm. One is nature related and the other is related to human made issues. Now, when you talk of natural made phenomenon that affect humanity, you know, we are today facing different sorts of natural hazards,
right,
like tsunami, cyclones, paucity of rainfall, pollution, so many things.
Right.
Then we need a perspective to understand why has it happened.
Mm-hmm.
Again, these are questions that we need to ask. Why has it happened? When it has occurred in the past, what was our strategy? How much did we invent? Which agencies did we depend on? And those steps that we followed, did it help to solve the problem? If it hadn't, then what more should be done? Today we should be very happy that as science and technology has advanced, today the warning systems have become very sharp.
Mm-hmm.
Before natural phenomena occurs, aap dekhiye aaj newspapers mein bhi aap padhi kahin cyclone aata hai, bilkul logon ki taiyari kitni zabardast hoti hai, less of human lives gets destroyed.
Mm-hmm.
People are evacuated, all this happens, but the disaster takes place. Therefore, what more should be done to arrest such things? For example, planting of trees, people should become more aware.
Mm-hmm.
About what are the agencies of pollution and so many things, actually looking into the problem, finding a solution and evolving a strategy.
Mm-hmm.
It also means allocation of budget. Where are we going to allocate? Are we trying to allocate towards addressing those issues? Are we trying to, within that, allocate budget for people who have faced the problem, how much we should give to them, food supply? I mean, so many indicators are there today.
Mm-hmm.
So it helps us to for better planning, and all the domains of knowledge are important, and these are the questions that we pose. What happened 5 years back and what has happened today, and how do we better plan for the future?
Mm-hmm.
So these strategies are very important in dealing with natural catastrophes.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there are other things that we can think about. One is the conflict and violence that our contemporary society faces. You can see this presentation that I have made from the interdisciplinary perspective. Now, if you look into conflict, there are one conflict that I would like to classify is self-made.
Mm-hmm.
We ourselves as humans face conflict day in and day out, because I may think differently, you may think differently.
Right.
Then there are larger bodies of conflict which are perpetrated by issues. A lot of research has been done, and therefore we cannot say a single factor is responsible.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if it is conflict that I face because of my complexes, because I am jealousies, or it is could be because intolerance, there could be multifarious reasons.
Mm-hmm.
Now, how do I address this? Those would require certain specific ways of addressing. I need to understand the causative factors.
Mm-hmm.
I need someone to counsel me. I also need someone who can repose confidence in me so that I speak to you.
Mm-hmm.
Sometime a teacher has this kind of personality. Parents also have such, and if they don't, they need to, because if the child keeps everything to him or herself, then it would be very difficult. And as you know, that when anything gets stored and the outlet is not there, it leads to visible conflicts, it leads to violence which we face.
Mm-hmm.
So in an interdisciplinary perspective, the causative factors are something which takes you to the domain of the past. Then when you evolve strategies,
mm-hmm.
you go to the domain of psychology, because the self has to be explored. What are the factors that are responsible? What kind of attitudinal changes to be required? What are the ways to do it?
Mm-hmm.
And if it is located in a place, now we have a good database to tell, what sort of violence, which age group does it affect more. So, all combined, I think it's the larger picture is an amalgamation of all disciplines, and therefore, the solutions that we can arrive at partly can be derived from interdisciplinary perspective. Sometimes people use the word multidisciplinary
right.
also. So, both these words are important because we as a problem solver need to explore and go into the depth of any issues and concerns mm-hmm. that we can. So, it is both important that this perspective needs to be worked upon, and I think a lot of work is being done and more is also being done so that people are looking for sustainable solutions.
Right. Ma'am, you mentioned about the term interdisciplinary and you just mentioned about multidisciplinary.
Yes.
It creates a lot of confusion.
See, I think it does not create a confusion because you have to understand the terminologies very well
mm-hmm.
and what you actually want to do. Sometimes it is within the discipline that you need to find an answer.
Mm-hmm.
But when you feel that the larger canvas has to be also explored, mm-hmm. then you go beyond.
Okay.
Maybe you have to enter the domain of science and technology.
Mm-hmm.
Science and technology definitely is facilitative, but it's very important what goes into the content of the technology. See, a lot of material gets developed, and today we are talking on the YouTube. But you need a material also to facilitate that dissemination.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if that dissemination is creative, it's designed well, and people like to see where they can get some solutions. So, if you work on it and make a presentation which is very creative,
mm-hmm.
I think it involves interdisciplinary within the discipline and across. You are the best judge to actually know what to do. Which discipline to tap more. Sometimes aapne koi ek theme ka chain kiya jahan ho sakta hai aapko bhugol ke bare mein jyada jankari chahiye.
Mm-hmm.
For example, I'm interested in studying a map because I want to locate places. I'm interested to know the routes that people followed. It could be trade, it could be market. I have to think creatively, and then it is the person who is doing that project or a theme they want to write an essay on. You are the best judge,
right?
Isn't it? So, this is what I would like to say.
Okay. So, ma'am, coming to the ways of addressing that strategies you have mentioned.
Yeah.
So, if you could just tell us more about it.
See, this is also something, an effective problem solving methodology. That is, if I want to seek a solution for a contemporary problem, the kind of questions that I pose for evolving short-term and long-term strategies is what was the method followed earlier for addressing, violence against women or it could be, natural
mm-hmm.
calamity. Then what is the present initiatives that are being taken? Are those initiatives well designed? Then what are the strategies of implementation? Because very many times, we know schemes are very well conceptualized,
mm-hmm.
but some way when they go down the line, there is a gap between the policy and the implementation.
Mm-hmm.
What more needs to be done? And it is there that these gaps that come have to be addressed effectively. Is it the absence of human power? Is it the budget that was not sufficiently thought about? Was the dissemination not very accurate so that people did not know about it? All these questions have to be posed before we go in for a futuristic planning, and therefore, these approaches in social sciences are very important.
Mm-hmm.
Then, how do we plan for the future? It's not just dealing with the present, it's also having a future perspective so that it can be lessons that can be, inscribed, people can work on it and maybe address issues in a better way.
Mm-hmm.
So, these are some of the strategies that I thought. And the questions that you can pose for is, first, the lessons learned. You can see this presentation. Then, it is very important to understand what are the roadblocks, because sometimes while implementing, there are so many, roadblocks that come.
Right.
And bottlenecks are coming because of certain issues. Therefore, how best we can address. Then, I said budgetary outlays. Then, Planning has also to be done for the short term, one that is achievable, that does not require so much of an outlay,
mm-hmm.
it's human, and then what are the futuristic ways of planning, long term perspective,
mm-hmm.
and therefore we always use the word perspective plan, it's 5 years, 10 years and so on and so forth. But the whole perspectives in social sciences, which is related to interdisciplinary approaches within and across,
mm-hmm.
you have to be very clear about the theme that you are taking. It could be, as I said, I gave you two examples, it could be settlement patterns, it could be anything that you think about, that has to be very, very clear.
Mm-hmm.
And once your theme is very clear, then you follow this approach. A questioning mind helps in creative creative pathways and bringing out solutions that are needed,
mm-hmm.
and can sustain over a couple of years together.
Mm-hmm.
So this is what I would like to say about the approaches, and I think as a teacher, as a student, and any stakeholders can do this for making social science responsive to societal needs. It could also help in making children understand the subject better, and it could also help in providing solutions to multifarious issues that we are looking into.
Right. Ma'am, there are two terms. One is roadblocks,
huh.
and other is examining budgetary outlays.
Huh.
So, if you could just briefly tell us, okay. what are roadblocks?
See, roadblocks are sometimes, you know, we are conceive of a very good initiative,
mm-hmm.
isn't it? And then we feel that yes, it will help in addressing societal problems. For example, it could be a law addressing issues of child marriage. There could be issues related to, you know, addressing different crimes against women.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is in place. But what happens is sometimes the person who is affected is not aware about it. Due to several reasons, maybe the dissemination method or the the awareness generation has not been so effective that they know about it. They are aware about the law, but they may not be aware about whom to go, whom to redress. Perhaps the confidence building is not taking place in the family, or the place of the redressal is much not near to the home where the person is staying.
Mm-hmm.
So this could be a gap, a roadblock.
Okay.
The other thing, because they are not aware, the language of dissemination could be coming as a roadblock in not making the person aware about,
mm-hmm.
the laws, not aware about the redressal mechanism. So this is one roadblock that I can think about.
Okay.
It. The other thing is that for example, there is a scheme that is getting implemented. Again, people are not aware about it, so they do not take the benefits of it. They don't know, and therefore they do not go. For example, there is a scheme where girls get enrolled,
mm-hmm.
for boarding facilities. So many times awareness generation programs are taking place. They are very effective. They may not reach the hard to reach spots. So the lack of going to that spot, which is hard to reach, also makes people not take the advantage of it.
Right.
So there could be several, but it depends again on what area that you are talking about.
Mm-hmm.
As far as the second question that you posed was allocation related. Now, for example, there is some allocation that is given for a program that I take, isn't it? We plan that we will spend so much on training, we plan so much on material development, we plan so much that we will finish at the mid-course. It happens,
right.
with every project that we take. But due to certain constraints, I am not able to realistically plan. I may plan a training program before,
mm-hmm.
and it may not occur at that particular point of time, or may not happen due to certain exigencies.
Right.
So when I plan, I should be very thorough with it, that will I be able to do, and then also plan about the exigencies that it may spill over,
mm-hmm.
but it cannot spill over endlessly. So there has to be realistic approach in identifying activities which I can do for spending purposes.
Right.
Now, and for spending purposes also, the heads have to be very clear. I plan for material development and I am not able to actually spend on material development, but I am spending on some other component. So, these allocations should be realistically planned, right, so that we meet the targets. This is what I would like to say, right. And there again you have to come into the domain of economics. So, this is the way I understand the subject, and I think that you are a student, you have a future to go. So, adopt this perspective with a questioning attitude, so that creativity, innovations and exploring multifarious pathway to address certain phenomena would be done effectively by you as a student. That's right. What I would like
very
to say.
Very well said, ma'am. So, today we very well understood about the perspective in social sciences, and for all this information, Professor Gauri, thank you.
Thank you.
Further, if you have any query or any suggestion regarding our any program, then you can dial into our toll-free number or can drop an email to us. Moreover, you can send your selfie or your video selfie along with your question on our WhatsApp number, which is flashing on your screen, and the number is 8076 754 6. And with this, I am signing off. Till then, take care and keep watching Kishore Munch.